Vaccines cause autism. I want to say before continuing with this video that although I do not support the ideas of vaccinations causing autism, I do support non-biased and reputable sources of information and studies. So some of you may be contemplating the ideas of vaccinations causing autism, maybe in your friends, maybe just as a general kind of in-depth for you, a bit of research for yourself, or maybe because your child has recently been diagnosed with autism. I find that anti-vaccinations because of autism is a very, very offensive topic, and is very much backed up by a lot of the autistic community. In this video, I will be talking about why I personally find anti-vaxxers' motives very offensive, and also within the autistic community being very offensive. Helping to get this information out and taken seriously, I believe, is a very positive step in order to raise the amount of acceptance and understanding of people with autism in the general media and in the general community. So, what makes an anti-vaxxer? Parents who are selfish, angry, victimized, and do not have a strong background in science may decide to look up different people's opinions, different controversial papers against anti-vaccinations in order to find a way of understanding what happened with my child and why is my child so utterly disabled by this horrible autism. As well as propagating the very biased and unstructured data that studies into anti-vaccinations present, it also promotes a very negative mindset towards a child, which can have serious psychological and confidence issues on the child when they grow up. These anti-vaxxers also serve to propagate the idea that we as autistic people are disabled, or it is a disease. When, in fact, if you talk to someone who has autism and someone who's understood what it is to be autistic, you will understand what it is about and how it isn't a disease. It isn't a negative thing, but something to promote diversity in a community. There is a very well-known psychological phenomenon where a person who has an opinion, so let's say the opinion is this vaccination has caused my son's autism, this autism is a bad thing and I feel very upset that it's affecting my child. So they will try and find some information on the subject, which is completely natural. But there are a few select people who are very unbudging on their opinion. So they'll look for information. They come across a few studies, they'll flick through it, oh, that's a little study, can't read that, it's too long. They find one, pick it up. Oh, this shows that this certain molecule in anti-vaccination fluid has been associated with autism. When in fact, these studies are very biased, they are supported by companies with a very bad moral compass that don't support the autistic community at all. And so they'll go on and they'll put that in their bag, and that'll add to their belief that autism is bad and that vaccinations cause autism. And they'll flip through some more and they'll find loads of them which are very reputable and good studies from good places that are very unbiased, and they'll ignore all of those, even though they will have very strong evidence to show that vaccinations don't cause autism, and they don't, you know, propagate autism in a child, even through birth. The best analogy that I can think of is if you were going to a river to find white rocks. So you had the assumption that all the rocks in the river were white. So you went through, you picked up a few, you picked 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 of really big brown stones, and you just chucked them to the side. As soon as you find a tiny little pebble, of white, pick it up, put it into your bag, and therefore you go home and say, hey, look at all the evidence I've found supporting this. Don't worry about all the other evidence that is very positive and shows that vaccinations that aren't correlated with autism. Look at this in small select biased information, and then you see the real picture. You see the real controversy that the us Americans or us British people are under, because our government's trying to turn everybody autistic, because that's really probable, isn't it? Because the government really wants everybody to be autistic. All these mindsets and these thought processes and these ignoring of certain pieces of information to affirm their beliefs about something is more or less showing to everybody and to themselves that they hate autism. And even if you are an anti-vaxxer and you say, well, hey, I do hate autism, I think it's a disease. Well, I believe that by saying that, you are in turn putting a lot of hate onto your child, because autism is not a disease, it's not catchable, and autism is a part of them, it's their brain. You wouldn't try to turn everybody into a guy called Melvin from the shop because his brain is you like his brain, you want everybody's brain to be like that. It's, oh no, my child isn't exactly the same as me and does not work in the same way as me, so therefore I'm going to be very angry about it, and I think that it's a really bad thing. Because looking in the history, we definitely don't have a history of, you know, racial discrimination and stuff like that, and sex discrimination and sexuality discrimination. Obviously, that's completely different from a person's unique brain structure, obviously. And yes, I am being sarcastic. I'm not pinning these anti-vaccine things on a single person or on the parents in particular. But what I am pinning it on mostly is the companies and organisations. And who do you think runs these companies and organisations? Usually, well, when I've looked and I've looked at the owners of corporations, they've usually been parents of someone who has an autistic child, or a lot older, and they have a science background where, when they were learning, autism was considered to be a disability and something to be frowned upon and removed. And these organisations spit out a lot of propaganda and a lot of negative ways of viewing autism in a very, I know what I'm doing light, and this is the answer, and we need to cure this, and we need to bring awareness to it because we need to cure this horrible disease. I mean, just look at things like Autism Speaks. You don't need to go very far to learn about which communities and organisations are unethical and they don't include anybody from the autistic community. So, we know that being an anti-vaxxer, whether there's evidence for it or not, there is a lot of evidence against it. And viewing autism as a disease is showing a lot of hate for your child, and it will psychologically affect them on a very deep level if you continue to treat them like they're a disease. But also, I recognise some of the companies and organisations that have been involved in propagating this. And this is really the reason why I'm making this video, because I want to address that these people, they don't, even though they speak like their word is fully backed up and fully supported by evidence, and they have no question about whether it's true or not, they may know nothing about what they're talking about, and they may just further be trying to propagate their idea, their opinion of autism being bad and vaccinations causing autism, putting that white pebble in the bag, ignoring all the brown pebbles, and propagating that into further parents, future parents, and really building up that kind of cyclical hate for autism that we really need to remove from the community in order for our society to be more accepting of Aspies, of autistic people, and generally improve our mental health and people's understanding of us. We know that humans naturally tend to avoid negative emotions and dealing with things head on. And in this case, with autism, the emotion is anger, and the emotion is victimizing ourselves as a parent in order to get some support from people and let people know that we're angry because our child's like this, and we're embarrassed that our child has autism, because maybe, or that they have a little bit of a tick during class, and one of the other parents who are completely non-understanding of it go, oh, your kid's a bit weird, and you can just say, oh, it's just because he's got this autistic disease or something. It's not because of that's who he is, because he's diseased, and they just want to save their own ego. If parents were only to accept that their child is different, and that their child is unique in different ways and positive ways, it may have a lot better of an impact on the child when they're growing up. They won't feel self-conscious about the way that they're built. They'll feel better about doing things. They'll have more acceptance towards other people, have better positive outlooks and motivation towards things, rather than, you know, someone in the class saying, oh, you're a bit weird, you like this, and they're just saying, my mum said I have autism and I have a disease, and that's just why I'm doing it. I'm trying to victimise themselves, because that's what you're saying. You're telling them they're wrong, and they're built wrong. And they're going to lean on that a lot, and that's going to be quite a inbuilt, you know, belief about themselves, which is very negative. Unhealthy values, severely reduced self-confidence, anxiety, depression. Those are just some of the things that could be caused by this very negative outlook towards your child, and it really needs to be stopped. I usually don't fuel my videos with a lot of emotion. It's usually very structured, but it's something that really resonates with me quite deeply. And when I see things like this, vaccinations on, you know, autism friendly groups and stuff, it really grinds my gears, and it's the kind of negativity that we don't want in our community. For those of you who have been reading into the science of it, and maybe not fueled so much by anger, and you're just interested in it, talking about the science, I have a big scientific background. I've done a lot of anatomy work, done a lot of brains, I've been to a very reputable university, researching, doing my own research into good papers that have a good standing within the scientific community. And some of the things that are suggested by anti-vaxxers and anti-vaccination propaganda and studies and stuff are very contrasting with what I've learned from good sources and reputable, you know, study of the brain and stuff. One of the reasons is when people think that their child can develop autism at a certain age, so they are not autistic, and then they get a vaccine and the chemical comes in and it turns them autistic. Now, if there was ever going to be a drug that turned people autistic, it would not affect someone physically as soon as they got it. It would affect their children, so the way that their children's made up, because autism is developmental. There's a physical difference in the connectivity between the brain, the actual anatomy. If you were to cut someone's skull open, if you were to do like an MRI, if you look at the image of their brain, it would be different, it would work differently, and the perceptions that we get would be worked differently, because there are tons of neurons going from the brain all to different peripheries and stuff, and they're very different in people with autism. They can be more sensitive. And suggesting that a molecule, a small molecule, even the strongest molecule, like, I don't know, if you're taking cocaine on a regular basis and you have marijuana and LSD and all of that, very strong compounds that cause changes in the brain, you would not be able to change someone's physical anatomy that much. And by saying this, I'm not saying that things like antidepressants and different diseases don't cause changes in the brain and the interactions between certain parts of the brain. It's just that it wouldn't be able to replicate the differences between autistic people and neurotypical people. So let's humour and say that this drug can cause autism. From the standpoint that myself and a lot of the positive people in the autistic community, and most of the autistic community in general, and people in general who have, you know, I've talked to her about it, they don't think autism is a bad thing and don't think it's a disease. However, what is a disease is measles, mumps, rubella, MMR, MMR vaccines. They are one of them, I think it was measles or rubella or something, one of those three, have such a high degree of infectious levels that 95% of the population needs to be immunized in order for there not to be an outbreak because it's so infectious. And these diseases kill people, and they cause deformity in people, injuries that last forever. So looking at autism, and it's not a bad thing, why would you want to get rid of this needed protective immunity to really harmful diseases that may, you know, last for an entire life, like hepatitis or something, just because you don't want them to have a different brain structure to you, and you're scared of how their brain works, or you don't understand, and you don't want to be tolerant of it? This is not a bad thing. So why would you want to do that? It baffles me, really. If you were to say, here you go, Tom, here's a non-autistic child, we've got a vaccination here, you know, there's been a lot of outbreaks of mumps and rubella because people haven't been vaccinating. Everyone's neurotypical, they're not autistic, but, you know, everyone's been vaccinated, not been vaccinated, and they're dying of mumps and rubella and all of those infectious diseases, and they're getting severely disabled. And you said, oh, there's a vaccine here, it turns them autistic, but, you know, it stops them from being killed. Would you be stupid to not take that up and not save their life because you don't want them to be autistic? So, what I encourage you to do, if you're still thinking of how your child is being affected or diseased by autism, just try these few things. Try accepting their autism. Try being positive about the things that autism has given them. Their intelligence, their unique perspective, their creativity, their imagination, their ways of coping with things that, you know, people usually push to the side, and their intense ability to work on themselves and to be a good member of society. There are loads and loads of positive reasons a person with autism may have. Loads of reasons, loads of good things that the person may have. And the only thing you have to do is change your mindset. You don't have to justify it. It's not going to help. You're not going to be able to change anything if you don't have a science background, if you don't have anything like that. The only thing you're going to do is spark more hatred and less acceptance and more negative mindsets on issues that are very, you know, important for people in the autistic community. You're making us feel bad. You're making the world less tolerant. And that's something that we really need to kind of get rid of. We really need to educate people. Being positive, accepting. It's what we need. So, in conclusion from this very long video that's needed, I won't be making these really long videos again for a long time unless I find something that's important enough to talk about. But there are a few things, you know, we need to conclude on. One, stay away from research papers. Let the scientists, let the reputable scientists do the work. If they feel like a vaccination is causing autism, they will change it. They don't want to turn everybody autistic, even though that wouldn't be a bad thing. Number two, get rid of that mindset of autism is a disease, autism is bad, and stop trying to victimize yourself as a parent or as a person, because you can't handle the social implications of your child having autism. And three, take time to talk to people who are autistic, who have Asperger's, who are older, who are successful. There are many people who are successful with autism or with Asperger's. And it's not a case of it being a negative thing. It's if someone brings a child up in a negative mindset, they're not going to achieve things. But if you give them a positive mindset and you accept them, they will grow and they will flourish. and they will become beautiful human beings.